2015 was the globe's hottest year on record, with the most significant El Niño event in nearly two decades. Perhaps unsurprisingly, it was a warm and mostly dry year for Australia. After a near miss last year, the Bureau officially announced the arrival of El Niño in autumn. Over the second half of the year, tropical Pacific Ocean temperatures warmed to well over 2 degrees above average, the signature of a strong El Niño event. Impacts from El Niño were felt around the globe. In the Northeast Pacific, a record number of tropical cyclones were observed, and drought in the Western Pacific has been particularly severe in Papua New Guinea. In Australia, El Niño's arrival was unwelcome news for areas already experiencing drought, such as inland Queensland and northern New South Wales. But over the course of the year, its influence was stronger in some parts of the country than others. After a wet January, very dry conditions prevailed from the Kimberley right through to the central Queensland coast and along southern coastal regions. However, record high temperatures in the Indian Ocean fed moisture over the continent from the west, producing much needed rainfall over some key agricultural areas during winter. From April through August, above average rain fell over parts of inland WA, New South Wales and eastern Victoria. Two significant east coast lows drenched about a third of the Australian population in late April and early May. By spring, a positive Indian Ocean dipole had developed, cutting off moisture from the northwest and reinforcing the impacts of El Niño in the Pacific. The result was the country's third driest September on record, with significant rainfall deficiencies for southern Australia. Tasmania had its driest spring on record, recording 18 millimetres less rainfall than the low set in 1914. The pattern of drying across the south is consistent with recent rainfall declines over autumn and winter, which were a signature of the millennium drought. 2015 was warmer than average for most of the country. It was Australia's fifth warmest year on record, with several significant heat waves and warm spells. We did manage to see some cold weather. Winter saw snow fall at low altitudes in Tasmania, New South Wales, and even southern Queensland. But the heat was on during spring. October 2015 was Australia's warmest on record, with a significant and record-breaking heatwave at the start of the month. Victoria's average monthly maximum temperature was nearly 6 degrees above normal, the biggest ever recorded departure from average for any state and for any month. In the past 3 years, Australia has recorded its three hottest springs on record. The combination of spring heat and low rainfall resulted in much drier than average soil moisture. This contributed to reduced stream flows and an early end to southern Australia's dam filling season. So how does 2015 fit into the broader climate picture? The warmth in Australia and the globe is consistent with background global warming of around a degree since the pre-industrial period. And based on the historical relationship between El Niño and global surface temperatures, it's likely that the record heat will extend into at least the first half of 2016. For the Bureau of Meteorology, I'm Karl Braganza.